गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास सेवेंथ सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस, चैप्टर नंबर वन सिविक्स ऑन इक्वलिटी। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट दिस चैप्टर। लेट अस फर्स्ट स्टडी व्हाट इज मीन बाय द डेमोक्रेसी। डेमोक्रेसी इट इज डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम टू ग्रीक वर्ड्स, डेमोस एंड क्रेटोस। डेमोस मीन्स पीपल एंड क्रेटोस मीन्स गवर्नमेंट। In other words, we can say it is a type of government of the people, by the people, and for the people. Listen again. It is a type of government of the people, by the people, and for the people. For the people. In this process, people can choose their representatives through elections by their cell phone. Now, the Constitution of India guarantees equality to all citizens, but there is very inequality among the people of India. These inequalities may be between the rich and the poor, educated and the illiterate people, high caste and the lower caste, and between the working class and the honors. The government has launched several programs to eliminate the inequalities, but very little has been achieved. In order to bring about a positive change, public awareness is very much necessary. Inequality exists in several democratic countries, but equality is a very important aspect in a democracy, and its functioning depends upon the people's participation. Now, our next topic is universal adult franchise. What is the meaning of universal adult franchise? It means each and every person, citizen, who is of age 18 or above can right to vote. And universal adult franchise is in practice in India since the first general election in 1952. Now, equal right of to vote, the meaning of equal right to vote is every adult citizen of India has a right to vote irrespective of his her economic status, religion, caste or education. Adult means 18 years or above, has a right to vote in an election. Now we will discuss about inequalities in our society. There are three stories we will discuss today. Story of Rama Devi, Om Prakash Valmiki, and Mr. and Mrs. Qureshi. Firstly, we will discuss about the story of Rama Devi. Rama Devi was a domestic worker, and the owner of Rama Devi is Ramesh Ahuja. On an election day, she goes to the polling booth in the morning and stands in a long queue. She finds Ramesh Ahuja is his owner, also standing in a line waiting for his turn to cast the vote. Second condition, but the evening finds Rama Devi standing in another queue with her sick daughter in the government hospital. But now, see, in both conditions are different. In the morning condition, both master and servant cast his or her vote in a queue, in the same queue. Both are equal, no matter if one is rich and other is poor. And both have one vote each, either a domestic helper or a owner, either a male or a female. Both are equal, as both of them have to stand in a queue and wait for the respective terms. But in evening, both are different. Ramesh Ahuja was a owner and Rama Devi was a domestic helper. Rama Devi could not go to work that day because of her daughter, and Ramesh Ahuja, who was the owner, he has not given the leave for this. And in this case, Rama Devi have the equal right when it comes to electing a candidate. but is miserably low below standard in various other aspects. That means in both the cases, in both the morning and evening, in both the cases, there is no equality. Only equality is in the polling booth line. Now, the next story is about Om Prakash Valmiki. In this story, the inequality imposed by the caste system. Om Prakash Valmiki was a very small child studying in class 4. He was a Dalit boy and who as a child was made to sweep the classrooms and school compound by the headmaster because he was of a lower caste room. He was made to sit at the back of the classroom and even he had to sit on the bare floor without the mat. He was made to sweep the classroom, the school and the playground for a couple of days. Even he was not allowed to drink water from the common tap. His misery came to an end when his father happened to see him sweeping and confronted the headmaster. This inequality was due up to his caste. Being a low caste student, he was not allowed to sit with the children of upper caste. For the same reason, he was made to sweep the classroom. This inequality was very shocking. Now, let us find another case. The last case of inequality in our society is Mr. and Mrs. Qureshi. Another case of inequality through the story of Mr. and Mrs. Qureshi who were refused house after house for over a month. That means all they wanted was a house on rent in a big city. They were live in Mumbai and they want a rented house. They have so much money, but they can't get a better place to live. So they have lot of money, but they were refused because they were non-vegetarian. They were Muslims, and though they had money, they were refused a house because of their religion, which was apparent from their name. So the property dealer, one property dealer with them and who was assisting them, asked them to change their name to Mr. and Mrs. Qureshi to Mr. and Mrs. Kumar. But they both had refused for this. They did not agree to the suggestion and were much put to inconvenience. So in these stories, we can see the inequalities in our society. Government has taken many steps to reduce the inequalities in our society. And the steps which government has taken, we will discuss in our next video. Thank you. Have a nice day.